Your speech explained the concept of rebirth. But saints and spiritual leaders say that we should break free of this cycle of rebirth and work towards moksha. Now, we need to go up in the spiritual path, but why should we do that? What am I missing if I say that I am very happy with my current life as a human being, doing the duties of a son, husband, father, and I know it is filled with happiness and sadness, but I still know how it feels. Why should I work towards enlightenment, which promises something that I have no idea about really?
Look, this is a very cutting question. You are allowed to ask such cutting questions. Please feel free, because we like to interact and it keeps us on our toes. Now, the idea is this. If any individual, any of our viewers, feel comfortable with the way things are, with their own lives, they're generating a great deal of happiness with their families and all that, look, you don't need to look for moksha. Moksha is not for you. Bluntly, I'm telling you, you don't need to worry about moksha or worried about gaining moksha, because you have no idea what that is anyway. If you are comfortable with your state of affairs, do not even think about moksha. I'm telling you bluntly. Look, it's only when life becomes jittery and we get buffeted and we feel something is seriously wrong here. Why am I getting smacked here, left, right, and center? We all have good times. We also go through very bad times. And most of us, when we mature, I'm not forcing you to mature that fast, but when we mature, we recognize that life is full of tremendous amount of suffering. This is a sign of a maturity. It may take long time, may take many lifetimes of getting buffeted before we recognize that life is not as straightforward as it looks. You know, like Sri Guru Nanak said, remember, this life that we are all sure about is full of suffering. Whole of Buddhism is nothing but recognizing that life is suffering. It is only when you begin to focus on that aspect, I'm not saying go become morbid and demolish your dignity yourself. You recognize that world is not really here for our convenience. It has a habit of buffeting and thumping us all the time. We get some good part, we kind of suck on the juicy parts, but overall, when you really do your balance sheet, you will find that life is hard. It is only when this particular feature becomes visible in your life, in your thinking, that you then say, okay, I want to now think about what the heck is this moksha thing? This Mr. Lakhani is talking about, what the heck is it? Why does it, why is it necessary for me to even think about it? So when you get buffeted, you say, is there a resolution to the human condition? That is the whole idea of Hinduism, resolving our human condition. So when you want to resolve, suppose you are happy with your lot, don't bother with moksha, I'm telling you bluntly. It's only when you become unhappy with your lot, saying something is not right here, I get thumped all the time, I chase after pleasure and pain keeps coming and whacking me. It'll come to all of us. Old age, disease, death, people being snatched away from our lives, all this is waiting. I'm not saying, oh, be morbid and kill yourself. I'm simply saying, recognize, this is like being a realist. When you become truly realist, say, no, I need to sort out. Then your spiritual journey begins. Until that time, you're fine, carry on as you are.